Hi, Lonnie Mackley here. I just want to talk to you a little bit today about some things. Basically, I just want to encourage you. This isn't like a formal study. The title of this message, if you want to give it a title, would just be From Survival to Revival. And there's many of you that have been waiting in the wilderness for a long time, the Christian wilderness, where God's just been purifying you, preparing you, in order to flow through you in power so that he can bring revival to this earth and he can harvest the souls here that need to be saved. And so many of you have gone through just a whole lifetime of this. You've just kind of been born in the wilderness, like I said before, and you've endured a life of restriction, a life of constant training from God, and just letting God basically shape his character in you so that he can flow through you and really help these people here. And now you've reached a place where you're at the end of your wilderness. You're actually at the last part of the last lap. And it's kind of a best of times, worst of times right now. You know, part of you knows that, you know, it's finally going to be over, but this is probably going to be the most difficult part of it, just like I said, the last part of the last lap. And many of you need healing really bad, I mean really bad, to the point where you're wondering whether you're going to survive or not. Your finances, you need a tremendous financial infusion to make it out of the wilderness and to transition out of this into your promised land ministry. God has pruned off many of your relationships, your primary relationships, and anything that could possibly hinder his work ahead, he's just pruned it out of your life. And so now here you are at the end of your wilderness, just kind of spent and wrecked in a lot of ways, and just wondering, you know, should I even bother going on here or not? Well, yes, you should, because even though you may be in this state right now, in 1 second, God can just change everything for you. And so don't trust in your own self of what you see, but trust in what God can do. I remember being at a place like that back in, I think it was 92, and while I was sleeping, God touched me while I was sleeping, and I just sprang right out of the bed, and from that, a lot of things happened, you know, just a tremendous infilling of the Holy Spirit. And what I learned from that is you can be just as fleshy and dead as you've ever been, and it only takes one touch from God to turn it all around. So don't think that you're done, that you should just give up, you know, and take your toys and go home, because God is still with you. He's been with you the whole way. He knew that you'd go through all of this when he called you, so this is no big surprise to him. Even your sin habits have been no big surprise to God. He's not falling off his throne over what you do during a day. He already knows. He's already seen the end from the beginning, and he knows how to bring you through this. And some of you have been dealing with certain types of sin habits that has been with you pretty much all of your life, and you've just hated it. You've wanted to get rid of it, and you just haven't been able to, no matter how many times you've tried to quit or change. And you just kind of been exasperated, just thinking, well, I'll never get free from this. Well, God is about to give you some extra grace and deliverance, where you're finally going to be free. And probably how that's going to come about, he's just going to give you a very clear, strong revelation about that thing that has had a hold on you, where you're just going to see it completely differently, and you're going to be able to let it go. And the truth, the revelation of God's truth, will set you free and keep you free. So you're finally going to be free of that, and that means, yes, you. I don't care how many times you've had to go through the ringer on this one, you're finally going to be free of it. You're not going to go back to it. And sometimes when, you know, we don't realize why we use some of these things, that they're meeting needs in our lives. We're using pleasure, even though it's sin pleasure, to relieve pain. So God's going to go after your pain too, those things in the past that you still feel guilty about, that you're beating yourself up over. God's going to give you revelation, and you're just going to see those things from a different point of view, and you're going to forgive yourself. And no matter whether the other people involved forgive you or not, you're going to forgive yourself, and you're going to move on with your life. And that thing will have no more power over you, what happened in the past. You're going to be free. God wants you fully free. I don't think that there was anybody that crossed over the river of Jordan into the promised land that, you know, were just so depressed that they couldn't walk across, or, you know, they were so sick that they couldn't get across. God's going to do everything necessary to restore you as you're crossing your spiritual Jordan River to make it into your promised land. And so you have to hang on for this last part. You have to take hope and believe in the same God that sought you out and saved you and has carried you all along the way, who's fed you with his daily manna, you know, in every way. And that's the same God that's going to show up and lead you through into your promised land. So you need to you know, just hang on. And another thing is you really need to watch your thought life right now. You know, laying in bed and just mulling things over and getting more and more depressed is probably not a good way to go. So get your nose in the Bible, be reading the Bible every day. Force feed yourself the word, whatever you need to do to get through this time, because it could be a little rough. Sometimes God goes silent on us, and those are the times where we have to watch our thought life the most, because that's when, if you're not taking every thought captive and disciplining your thought life, that's when those thoughts get in there, like, oh, God's forsaken me, you know, I must be so wicked and evil, God's given up on me. And, you know, there's a demon right there by your side going, yeah, you're right, God's just done with you, and you might as well give up, and you might as well just die. And it's kind of like Job's wife, where she said, you know, just curse God and die. You're going to feel like that sometimes, like just cursing God and wanting to die. But that's only going to make things harder for you, and it's a complete lie. Because God loves you, God has forgiven you, God has a great plan for you, and you're just going to have to hang on to Him. Just hide yourself in the folds of His robe right now and just hang on as tight as you need to on that robe to get through the last part of this, because God is with you. There's going to be a time extremely soon now where God is just going to show up like never before in your whole lifetime. But right now God has just been putting the finishing touches on you. He's been doing a final cleansing to get rid of those things that could hinder or ruin what God's going to do, because these things, you cannot take them with you. There's things that if you were to take them with you, or even people, if you were to take them with you, they would bring down the things, like, you know, certain types of things in your life. They would, you know, those demons would expose them, they'd discredit you, and it would just drag down and ruin everything that God wants to do. So it's really critical that God has this extra last amount of time to prune these things out of your life and to get rid of them, to amputate them from your life once and for all, so that that cancer in your life of sin is gone, finally gone. And as everything is finally removed from your life, you're going to feel a bit of a void. The door to the past is closed, and the door to the new is not quite open yet, so you're going to feel a bit of a void. And you're going to need to really, you know, stand up and press into the things of God to get through this kind of void time where you're not hearing God's voice a lot. Press in. This is the time where you can give God your best gift of faith by just saying, no, I'm not going to listen to those horrible thoughts. I'm going to press in. I'm going to trust God. I'm going to get my nose in His Word. I'm going to pray, and I'm going to worship whether I feel like it or not. And I'm just going to press through this time, and I'm going to encourage other people rather than, you know, complaining or groaning about everything. I'm going to press in, and I'm going to get close to God, and I'm going to trust Him whether I hear from Him or not. And I'm speaking to somebody specifically today. You're just wondering, does God really love you? Does He really care about you? Yes. Yes, He does. And He knows about these things that have been weighing heavy on your heart. He knows about your heartbreaks. He knows about all these things that seem to be left undone. He knows how you feel about it being too late about things. And He is able to do miracles in your life where it's never too late. Look at Abraham and Sarah. It looked obviously too late for them to have a miracle child, but it wasn't too late. Things are never too late for God. And you've just got to trust that God will make a way. And just like Abraham and Sarah, where they tried to get creative and make a way in the flesh to get their miracle to happen, you don't need to do that. And even if you know, one of those kind of Ishmael answers drops down right in front of you, you don't have to go that way. You can trust God for the miracle that you've been waiting for so long, because He's about to do it. And you need to hang on and trust Him, because restoration is coming. And God just wants you to hang in there right now and to trust that very, very soon new doors are going to be opening up for you. But allow Him to just get rid of these last few things that have been plaguing your life. You're going to be so glad that you spent the last part of this time getting free from it. No matter what the problem is, if you've had a problem with porn, with addiction, smoking, profanity, whatever these things are, they're going to become more pronounced so that you'll be able to face them now and finally get rid of them. And just trust that what you cannot do in your own strength, you can do with God's grace. And He's about to give you a fresh outpouring of grace. And He's about to visit you in a way that you've never been visited for, and just before. And just like Moses at the burning bush, you're about to have a burning bush experience with God. And the best thing you can do, the best gift that you can give Him right now, is just to keep trusting Him, just to keep seeking Him right now, and to be praying, and know that He's going to come through for you. Jesus is not going to just leave you as an orphan. He's just going to come through for you. And you're about to start a wonderful, wonderful time of ministry. And you'll be ready for your ministry this time. You're going to be able to stand strong this time. And you'll be able to be above reproach this time and unshakable. And you're going to bear a great harvest for the King. And God is going to begin to flow through you with His power. You're going to begin to pray for people, and they're actually going to get healed. And this is just going to keep doing from morning to night. It's going to be nothing but a series of miracles, first series of miracles for you to restore you, and series of miracles just as you go about your daily business. Everywhere you go, there's a potential miracle that's going to happen. And when it does, just preach the gospel to these people, just like they did in the book of Acts. When God moves, just preach the message of the gospel as soon as God does something, whether He heals somebody or delivers somebody in the middle of McDonald's from a demon, or however the miracle comes. Just preach the gospel, pray for the sick, and let them know that God loves them, that God is waiting to forgive them, and that He stands ready to be their King and their Lord. Okay, my friend, bless you. Oh, I wanted to mention, if you go to my YouTube homepage, there's a Twitter account, a new Twitter account with a little bluebird on the right side of the page. Click on that little bluebird, go to my Twitter page, and click the follow button. What I do is I post different prophetic messages and encouragements on there every day as I feel led. So go there and just hit the follow button. And also there's other links there for you to be able to get ministry from, whether it's Spirit-Led Recovery from Addiction or Revival Prophetic Wilderness. There's links there to go to. And if you feel led when you're there, hit the PayPal button and give an offering. I do a lot of counseling for people that are recovering from addictions and people that need help from God. So hit the PayPal button, give an offering, and may the Lord bless you for it. Okay, my friend, have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.